6 glass panes. The tougher the challenge, the more points the pane of glass is worth. Smash through them all and get past the gates to the final pane, and the bonus points are yours. Now watch out for the robotic harass, because they're covered for you, baby.
Let's go down to our robot expert, Dan Dignan, who's standing ringside.
Thanks, Tanya. Hammerhead's design is really different. He's like two robots joined at the hip. He can move this way and this way at the same time. He's so flexible, he'll be able to breeze over the obstacles like the speed bumps. But he's going to have a hard time maneuvering in the corners, where his relatively large turning radius could spell trouble. Mini-Rip has the same ground clearance as Hammerhead, but driver Chris Handel has got to get his speed under control. If he can do that, I think he's got the edge. Back to you.
Thanks, Dan. Ezra Mathewson's Hammerhead is pulling in on the left, and Chris Handel's Mini-Rip has pulled in on the right. Both have added glass breakers for this event. It looks like Hammerhead and Mini-Rip are in position, and we're ready to get on Labyrinthar. Let's do it.
Robot sway.
And the Labyrinth is underway. We got to fight Mini-Rip lifted in the corner completely upright as Hammerhead goes after him. Oh, but Hammerhead loses the glass breaker as Mini-Rip falls off. Nice.
He better back off, Ahmed. If he loses another glass breaker, he's done for.
He doesn't seem to care, man. He's still ramming Mini-Rip, but now the plow gets underneath him. There's the Mini-Rip cam as Hammerhead gets lifted. Oh, turnabout is fair play, and Hammerhead is jammed at the turntable. Mini-Rip slams him, and now Mini-Rip backs off. Time for points. Chris Handel works across the rear speed bump. These two bots came in here tied. It's crucial. They both get points quickly.
It looks like Hammerhead is going towards the corner with the flip ramp and the sand. Both require very precise steering. Automotive-style robots have notoriously had trouble with the sand, because if you have to turn in a tight space, trailing wheels require more room to maneuver than tank steering.
He's going for it. His wet sticks there. And he gets the 25 points. He's trying to straight up, man. Mini-Rip going for the spikes. Lining up backwards. He ties it at 15 points for him. He's down by 10. He's coming up backwards too. Dan, why is this?
I'm guessing to avoid denting his plow on the spikes, on it. If he bends it, bends it down, it could mess up his ground clearance.
Dan's got an answer for everything. Hammerhead's lining up the whip ramp. No room for mistakes here, and he swims right across. Gets 20 points. Deadfield stands his lead. Mini-Rip tries to keep pace at the bridge.
And this driving is all about clearance. That plow would definitely stick on the bridge if it goes forward.
20 more for Mini-Rip. The lead is still 10 with two obstacles to go.
Hammerhead's now in trouble, Ahmed. He has to turn completely around in this narrow alley, and there's very little room. He's doing a multi-point turn here, but it's taking an awful lot of time.
Now he goes for the ramp. Oh, he's sideways! He lifted! Oh, somehow staying upright! Andrew Mathewson almost bought it!
Yeah, Ahmed, he can run upside down, but he has no glass breaker anymore.
Mini-Rip fighting his way back across the speed bump. Chris looking to get a better vantage point here. Mini-Rip is through the saloon door, and he's going for the rollers. Boy, he just loves running this horse backwards, Dan. Got an explanation here?
Okay, his glass breakers are closer to his plow end, so going backwards gives him more time to accelerate than into the glass.
Good enough. Mini-Rip gets the 25 points. Now he's in the lead. The only obstacle left is the box, and Hammerhead's being harassed by the Red Rat, who's finally gotten involved. Hammerhead up the rail. He's got to get by. Oh, he's going around, but he's still going the wrong way. The box is straight ahead. He's taking the long route over the speed bumps, and Red Rat's going to get his way, too. He loses that glass breaker, but does get by. Maybe he's going after Mini-Rip.
Interesting situation here, Ahmed. If Hammerhead gets the box, he ties Chris, and it all comes down to the bonus pain. If Mini-Rip gets the box, but Hammerhead gets the bonus pain, we've got an overall tie, and both can move on to the fight to the finish.
And the box collides! Hammerhead on top of Mini-Rip, neither side back and down. And now they're both going for the jump. Oh, the box is straight ahead. Mini-Rip seems to be holding the inside position here. Hammerhead back through the saloon doors, and now Mini-Rip heads for the box. Ithiel's trying to get Hammerhead moving. He needs to catch up. Mini-Rip, is he waiting for him? He turns around. Oh, backing into the box, and Hammerhead joins him. Oh, who's going to get through first? Mini-Rip is doing the pushing here. Oh, and obviously keeps the gap small just enough for him to slip through. And he's got the point! Hammerhead bumming, but he can still get the tie and gets the bonus pain. There's the siren, and Mini-Rip goes after Hammerhead. No way Mini-Rip can lose. But he'd much rather face only one opponent on the fight than the finish platform than two.
Hammerhead's got that wedge down. He needs to raise it up if he wants to knock down those gates.
Hammerhead spinning those tires, trying to push Mini-Rip out of the way. He hits those gates again, but Mini-Rip's having none of it. They're fighting the saloon doors now. Time becoming a factor. Hammerhead fighting that steering, through that angle, though. The ring's not letting him reposition. Oh, this is tense. I would love a three-way fight to the finish. The Hammerhead's losing valuable time here. He gets free, but he still can't push Mini-Rip. The rats are mostly watching as Mini-Rip gets under Hammerhead. Hammerhead's tires are spinning. And there's the buzzer. Oh, it's not meant to be, but what an incredible round of competition. Maybe the closest we've had all year, but in the end, Chris Hamill and Mini-Rip come out of that.
There was no obstacle these bots couldn't handle as they cleaned up the labyrinth. It came down to a shoving match, and ultimately the hinged Hammerhead was only pushing with half his butt, which gave Mini-Rip the strength to hold him off and hang on to the victory.
And we've got our first competitor in tonight's competition. It's Mini-Rip! Mini-Rip wins with 75 points over Hammerhead's 45.